Today, we're going to be building some computers virtually. Now, as some of you guys may know, and I mentioned in my last video, I used to work at a company called Geek Squad, affiliated with Best Buy, and what we did there was we specialized in software repairs for clients. Now, there's a lot of misconception where some people think that Geek Squad agents aren't able to build computers or do anything of that sort. I'm here to kind of break that misconception. I'm pretty proud of my journey at Geek Squad, and I no longer work there. I collectively worked there for about 3 years or so. To admit, Geek Squad doesn't teach their agents how to build computers. The knowledge that I gained from Geek Squad was more so working with clients, and they did have some software that they have in store to kind of help with some software repairs. But all of the knowledge that I gained from building computers mainly came from outside of Geek Squad, and I eventually brought that in and taught my team. Over the years, I did build some computers for clients as a special request, which isn't typically what they do. It depends on the location, if I'm being honest. But yeah, I did build a couple of computers, and I'm pretty confident because today we're going to be playing PC Building Simulator. So let's get right into it. So I'm pretty confident. This is actually my first time playing, so I'm not really sure what to expect, nor did I really watch any videos of this game, but I guess we can start a new game here. That looks pretty cool. Looks like an RTX, so probably like a 30 or 40 series. And this kind of looks like a Lian Li case, but it says ROG here, so it's an Asus case. All right, let's see. Okay, looks like there's stages. Again, I'm not really sure what to expect hopping into this game. I literally just bought it this morning. To begin, go to your PC by the doorway and open the email program on the desktop. You've got mail. Okay, so it looks like some sort of or first person view. It says, I forgot what it said already. Ever feel like there just aren't enough hours in the day? Between work, family, and everything else, cooking a delicious home-cooked meal can feel impossible. That's where HelloFresh comes in. With HelloFresh, you get fresh, pre-portioned ingredients and easy-to-follow recipes delivered right to your door. No more last-minute grocery runs or stressing about what to cook. Personally, as a content creator, HelloFresh allows me to free up more time in my day by eliminating meal preparation times. That means less waiting time for my viewers during my dinner breaks. Whether you're a seasoned chef or just getting started, HelloFresh makes cooking fun, easy, and fast. In about 30 minutes, you can whip up a delicious meal that you'll be proud to serve. Plus, with a rotating menu of over 50 recipes each week, there's always something new to try, from comforting classics to exciting global flavors. So why wait? Join the millions who've discovered the joy of cooking with HelloFresh. Order today and get 10 free meals and free breakfast for life. So what are you waiting for? Use my link in the description down below to start ordering from HelloFresh now. Thank you, HelloFresh, for the sponsor. Where do I check the mail? Do I go outside? Oh, okay, okay. No, I don't want to end the day. PC can boot into OS, remove viruses. So we pick this up. Okay, here. Cool. Okay, so we're placing the computer here. So PC can boot into OS, remove viruses. Okay, so it's not really particular on what it says I'm supposed to. Oh, I guess the computer has a virus. How do we do this? Okay, what would I do as a Geek Squad agent? Well, this seems more like a software issue if it's something to do with the virus here. Oh, email. Okay, right. We're supposed to check our mail. Okay. Here we go. So this is the client's computer. Cool. So this is from gobin at allthemail.com. Hi, Tim. I guess I'm Tim. I hope you can help me. My computer has been running slower than usual, and I think I might have clicked on something I shouldn't have. Do I have a virus? All right. Okay. So it's running slower than usual, so this could be a drive issue. So sometimes when your computer is running really slow, I mean, it can be a virus, of course, but it depends on the age. If the client was here in person with me, I would ask them, okay, how old is the computer? If they built it within maybe a year or two, I would assume that they're using a M.2 or a SATA drive, which should technically be fast. Now, if the operating system is running on, operating system being Windows 10, Windows 11, whatever, If it's running on an older hard drive, over time, that will slow down exponentially. So those are the questions I would probably ask my clients, but it seems like this one is just, the game is trying to lead us to think that it's just a virus scan, or it's a virus. Let's try it out. Okay, so plug the PC in. For this job, you need to run a virus scan. Press 3 or the keyboard button to plug in the monitor. Okay, so cool. Okay, cool. This is so easy. So they're giving us this little point of view here. Can I zoom out? Ooh, I can't zoom out much. Okay, so you have to hold it. And then, so this is the power supply cable. And then this is HDMI. And then insert the USB drive. Now you need to put in the USB drive in the back of the PC so you can install the virus scanner. That is actually really similar to Geek Squad. We do have a USB drive with software in it to, so we don't want to boot into the OS. For example, if it is a very serious virus, most of the times, first things first, what we do is we do something called a face scan. But the face scan typically scans all of the hardware in the computer as well. And then after the hardware scan, it tells us if the computer is working as it should. And then afterwards, we'll run a software scan, making sure that there's nothing on the drive, making sure there's no viruses. So this is kind of realistic, to be honest. This is pretty cool. So I think we gotta plug in the USB that they're mentioning here. But where is the USB here? Install a part of component USB drive. Here we go. Okay, cool. Now press the P or power button to turn on the PC. To click on the monitor to use operating system of the machine. Okay, so the computer is booting on now. I guess we can see the this. Install the virus scanner. Welcome to Omega OS. So it's not Windows. The operating system of the choice. Click on add remove programs to install the virus scanner. And don't forget to reset the PC after it has installed. Okay, so we're going to add that program here. Where's the virus scanner? Quick and simple. Very straightforward. We're installing it. And they're requesting that we reboot the computer after we install the virus scanner. Dude, that is slow. What is happening? Yes. All right, let's rebooting. So PC can boot into OS. Boom. That's good. That is a good sign. So if the PC can boot into the OS, that is a really, really good sign that the PC, all the components are working as it should. All right. Now that we have the virus scanner here on the desktop, we can start scanning, I guess. Okay, so there is a virus that is found. Clean files. You have to remove all the viruses and the PC is ready to be returned to the client. Pick up the PC with the right mouse button and place it in the delivery area. Nice. I'm wondering if we can like screw up the computer somehow, just like remove the graphics card and return it to the client. That would be kind of funny. Yeah, how do I unplug all this stuff now? Okay, remove. Okay, remove, remove, remove. It is kind of similar to Geek Squad. I mean, the back end of Geek Squad. The hardest part about Geek Squad isn't the PC repair on its own. The hardest part about working at Geek Squad is talking to the client, making, like, you know, helping them calm down. You know, they're bringing in their broken computer. They're stressed out, right? They're upset. And they just want their computer back. So how I saw the position was I felt like a doctor. Like, you know, sometimes you deliver bad news. Sometimes you deliver good news. It's you deliver results to your client. And what Geek Squad taught me is that, you know, you gotta really level with your client. You gotta have empathy, and you have to have understanding. And that's where I think I personally really excelled as a Geek Squad agent. You know, I talk to my clients 10, 15 minutes, however long they want, just to assure them that their computer is in the right hand. Me. Do we have to email? Typically, after we were done the computer, I email, like, we email or we give the client a call, like, hey, it's ready for pickup. But yeah, no, this whole work scenario kind of avoids that front-to-front confrontation with a client. You're dealing, it seems like, you know, they mail the computer to you, you read, and then you just fix it in your little office space, which is cool. Personally, I prefer that. I just want to, okay, so this is the follow-up with the client. I just want to say thank you for fixing my PC. It's booting faster than it has in years. I didn't realize your uncle had gone away. Looks like the business is in good hands though. So, okay, so there's a little like lore behind the game. That's kind of cool. So we're Tim, our uncle owned the shop, and we're, I guess, taking over for our uncle. That's sick. That's pretty cool. Okay, but it looks like his computer is working well. So let's see. We got a couple of clients here. Could you have a look at my PC, please? It isn't running as well as it did when I first bought it, and I've probably not been taking the best care of it. It looks a bit dirty. Could you give it a once over, please? Okay, so we got to do a physical cleaning. That's something that we did offer at Geek Squad as well. I did physical cleanings, which is really fun. That's one of my favorite parts of the jobs. Seeing all that gunk kind of fly everywhere. I can have it ready. So this one looks like it's just a PC cleaning. I want to try something a little bit tougher here. So this one is, hi, my graphics card has fried itself and I need it to be replaced with the same one, please. An NVIDIA GTX 970, maybe one of those Sheen ones. Is he stats? What does he have right now? So we got to make sure. So before we, so he has a 970 already. He wants to replace it with the same card. So we don't have to really worry about the power supply here. It's 400 watt. Considering it's the same card, we can just replace it with the same card. No issue without worrying about the power supply. Yeah, let's take that. Let's accept that. He wants the Sheen one. So there's two different models here. They're both same wattage. One is more pricier because it has a higher core frequency and memory frequency, but his budget is 265. So we're just gonna this one right here because this is over budget. I screwed up here. I only have $85. Okay, it allows me to go into negatives. Okay, we're good. Okay. The customer's PC is here. Go to work. Your new parts have arrived. Click on the boxes to put them in your inventory. So these are the two client PCs and these are the boxes. That's a lot of boxes for a graphics card. This one is... Yeah, let's install the graphics card first. I'm excited for this one. So we should have the graphics card in our inventory, right? How do I get... Oh, right here, install. Okay, but we need to open it up first. Remove. Oh, there's one screw and... Oh, okay. Very nice. So it looks like there's no... Taking a closer look here, guys. So this is his PC build. Typically, modern day computers will have a power supply, a PCIe cable routing to the graphics card. But it looks like, I don't know if it's because it's a 970 and 970s didn't require that at the time, or if it's because it's a game thing. But yeah, we just got to remove this and install the new one. So remove case part. So this is where it would typically be screwed down here. So that's exactly what I would do first. Let's remove that. There's the screw and let's take that out. Nice. Looks like there's more here. Do I have to remove them all? Okay, it's open now. There should be a little tab here that we have to press down before we remove it, but I guess we can just remove it like that. But guys, don't just yank out the graphics card. Make sure to press this little tab before you go ahead and remove it. Also, make sure nothing's plugged in. Sometimes this is a rookie mistake. This is earlier on in the day when I tried to remove a graphics card. I still had one of the HDMI cables plugged in. You cannot remove the graphics card if the HDMI cable is plugged in. Just want to let you guys know that. Now we can install the graphics card. We should have the... I wonder if he wants this back. Because yes, we can definitely sell that and then make some... That's something I would do, to be honest. GTX 970 is the new one. And we just go ahead and we just install it. Now we can just put everything back in. Let's just go ahead and start the... Let's just boot it on. We have to enter the BIOS. Okay, it works right off the bat. Cool. I mean, typically what I would do though is as soon as we install the graphics card, I would check the graphics drivers. I just want to it's common practice to make sure that you have the right software, updated drivers for the graphics card before you give the computer back. Because if there's any issues with any games, they're going to automatically assume it's you, right? They're like, oh, you installed the graphics card for me. This game isn't working. It could be something as small as, you forgot to install the drivers. My rule of thumb as a Geek Squad agent is that I always assume that the client doesn't know any better. Not in like a derogatory or like to put them to shame sort of way. It's more so they're coming to me for help, right? If they're coming to me for help, I'm going to pretty much try to teach them as much as possible to make their experience with the computer once they get it back as smooth as possible. So the next time that they come back, it won't be a complaint for a repair. It will be, you know, maybe there's something else that is an issue and they trust me to, you know, work on their computer again. Incomplete case, yeah, so we just need to remove this stuff now. Computer, done. So the next one is, I believe it's a PC cleaning and checking for viruses. So physical cleaning as well as a software cleaning. Let's pick it up. Ooh, this looks dirty. Yeah, no, dude, you need a cleaning for sure. At Geek Squad, we typically have like something on the ground that, ooh, can we mess around with our computer. Damn, that's cool. Okay, let's we'll mess with that later. With Geek Squad, what we do have is like this huge like electronic fan, like this compressed air. I don't know if it's compressed, but pretty much it's really, really loud and it's electrical, and we use it to clean computers, and I love it's so satisfying. Now, cleaning a PC. So it actually tells us beforehand. Press the install button and get the compressed air from your tools. Then you click on the PC's component to blow away the dust until it has all been removed. Should be somewhere here, right? Tool, software, compressed air. Blow out dust. Is it working? It does not look like there's any difference here. Oh, this is sick. Okay. Should I remove the front panel too? Oh, yeah, it looks pretty clean though. This is awesome. Okay, it's looking brand spanking new. That is looking pretty good to me. All right, so we got to level 2. I mean, I could probably play this game for hours upon hours. How does PC Building Simulator compare to working in an actual like shop, computer shop, Geek Squad? Well, a lot of those things that I did, I mean, well, I would say it's a 50-50 for now. It is in the early game. Like the whole software thing was pretty accurate, if I'm being honest. Like we would, if somebody says that they have a virus, we would bring it in and we would actually use a USB to get the virus removed. Whether it be booting into the operating system, Windows, for example, and running our virus scanner, or not booting into Windows at all and using the USB to just boot in directly and then doing a physical scan of the hardware as well as the software. But it looks like the USB is just a program that you have to use within the operating system. So I'm sure as you get like later into the game, it gets more complex. Yeah, I made some rookie mistakes, to be honest. Like I forgot to reapply the thermal paste for the CPU cooler. But the one thing I want to mention is that not every single Geek Squad agent, I do admit, actually understands computer components. They might only specialize in just software, so using that USB that Geek Squad does provide. But the game is really, really fun though. And as a computer enthusiast myself, not just from Geek Squad, but just from learning like on YouTube on my own, the game is somewhat accurate. I remember like working in the shop and I'd be so exhausted because you know, you're just carrying computers and you're lifting it, and like sometimes you have to reach in specific areas and it hurts your fingers. Like plugging in those PCIe cables on the motherboard, dude, that can just really do some damage to your fingers. I would whenever I built a computer, I would always go home with like cuts on my hand. I did get a really good question, so I asked my Discord, you know, if there's any questions. One man ban says, question for the video. What is the process at Geek Squad when someone brings a PC in that's not working properly? Also, would you recommend taking your PC to them? It's really broad, I guess, the question. Like if the computer is not working in general, for example, you press on the power button of your computer and it doesn't turn on at all, I would assume it's hardware. Now, it depends on the day for me personally working at Geek Squad, because I can honestly just say I work with software and I can turn away the computer just depending on how busy we are. It could be something like as simple as the cable plugged into the motherboard isn't, it maybe got loose. Maybe if you're traveling a little bit, that cable could get loose, and when you press the power button, it won't turn on because that cable is not plugged in. Or it could be as complex as something as like the power supply. Personally, I know these things, but I can't speak for every single Geek Squad agent. A lot of the Geek Squad agents will turn away your computer if it is hardware related. So if you do have any speculation that there is hardware damage on your PC, I would highly advise not bringing it to Geek Squad. Because I don't work there anymore. I'm just kidding. And if they do take it in, they are going to charge you some crazy amounts because the agents in store is not going to work on it. It's going to be the repair depot. The repair depot being an entirely different department of Geek Squad that works mainly with hardware, and for the labor and everything like that, they are going to charge you some absurd amounts. The prices that I saw there, though, I would say is like, it's pretty accurate, though. If I'm being honest, for PC Building Simulator, I don't know if it was like an exaggeration, but those prices were pretty accurate. So all in all, would I recommend bringing your computer over to Geek Squad? Again, if it's for hardware, don't do it. If it's for software, for viruses, anything like that, maybe you need a consultation, yeah, go for it. All in all, it really depends on the agent that you get. I had a lot of fun playing PC Building Simulator, guys. If you guys enjoyed this video, please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. I am trying to do some more experimental videos. Doing something like this was actually amazing. I'm trying to change it up. We just reached 1,600 subscribers on the channel, so can we get a pog in chat? If this video does get a lot of support, though, I will consider buying PC Building Simulator 2, and we can probably play that, or we can just do another episode, maybe a longer episode, or maybe even a live stream of the game. Like, who knows? My name is Leo, aka Leonidas. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.